blatant commercial advertising on Ham Radio Now, episode, again, I don't know the number, you can see it down there on the screen.
Down there?
Yeah, right down there. Hey, Tom, welcome back to Ham Radio Now.
Thanks.
You're only here because you make shirts and now other products.
Now other products, yes.
That have my logo on them.
Yes,
we do. Pick up something with my logo.
Right over there. Grab your coffee cup over there. There we go. Yeah. Really nice coffee mug they can now get with your
with logo. My logo, but not just my logo.
Sure.
You'll sell someone else's stuff on it as well.
Well, right? Yeah. We will do customs if they want it, and all customs for clubs and people and what have you, but yeah.
Okay. So the company is hamshirts.com.
Yes,
right?
Sir.
Okay. We got to make sure everybody knows what the blatant commercial advertising is for. Although I say blatant commercial advertising, you're not paying me for this.
No. Nah.
At least I don't think you are. We haven't signed a contract or anything.
No, not that I know of.
But you did. You have made the Ham Radio Now shirts. There's one sitting back there. And I promised that if I saw one at Dayton, that the guy would get on the show. And he's still sitting in the editing bay. He's not on the show yet.
Oh no!
Maybe tell you what. I'm gonna edit that now, and stick that in. We move over to Dayton, Ohio, at the Dayton Hamvention from last year. And talk to a guy wearing a Ham Radio Now shirt. We'll be right back. Get a nice close-up. Nice close-up right there in the middle to start with. Here, I'll get a nice close-up right in the middle to start with the POV cam.
I have it.
Okay. And I have it. And we widen out. And we say, we have found the golden T-shirt.
You have. Earl, VE7QJ from Vancouver, British Columbia. Actually, Maple Ridge, British Columbia.
So you have come with a Ham Radio Now T-shirt from a totally different country.
Altogether outside of the USA, yes.
So how did this occur to you to do?
Well, actually, I saw the episode 142, perhaps, maybe 143, and I heard you talk about it.
Don't do a Star Trek thing on me. Oh, no. Back in episode 142, when you were talking to this guy.
Exactly. Anyway, I saw the advertisement, and you guys talked about it. So I went to the site and I said, well, I'm going to get one of those. And then somewhere along the way, you mentioned the fact that if I wore the T-shirt and you spotted us, you'd do a video. So here I am.
And I was worried that, you know, somebody would buy the T-shirt just to come on and embarrass me. So I do I have to do any editing here?
No editing whatsoever. We're going to keep it straight.
You clearly like the show.
Oh, yes, absolutely. I've watched you from the very beginning back in Orlando, Florida. When you did the first 8 episodes, I think, with the various vendors and whatnot that were there, found it immensely interesting, and I thought, well, this is worth following, and I've watched you since then.
Well, you know, Canadian, so, you know.
Does that explain it all, really? Okay.
Let me practice my Canadian. Eh?
Eh, that's right. That would be the one.
I'm trying to offend everybody possible up there. For some reason, I'm not sure why.
Exactly. Well, anyway, so yes, we've followed you since then through, haven't watched every single video, but quite a few. I try to spread the word around up there about who you are and what you do. And we have you have a number of followers up there, and they enjoy it.
You know who else has not watched every single video?
Who?
The guy sitting to your left.
Jeff.
And we found Jeff. There's Jeff. What have you been up to today?
Hi, everybody. Okay. I've been doing Hamfest stuff. Notice I don't have my Ham Radio Now T-shirt on. And now I'm embarrassed by it, too, because I didn't think I was going to run into you guys. But it's nice to see everybody.
You have run into people, though.
I have run into people. It's been somewhere between a dozen and 20 people that have said, I see your shows. Hi, Jeff.
And you have no ID. You're not identified.
Oh, well, I got...
As Ham Radio Now.
I'm not identified. That's
You're
right.
You're not carrying the mic flag.
Nothing that says Ham Radio Now,
I actually
right.
I actually spotted him from across
microphone
the room.
Jeff.
He was all sitting by himself.
Oh, me?
You've forgotten your job.
Oh.
Yeah. I was just saying that I actually spotted Jeff from across the room, and I went, okay, so there's the camera, there's Jeff, so where's Gary? And you were over there doing a phone call.
Oh, okay. So, yeah, right here. Yeah, I was trying to get a signal on Verizon, which is really bad here inside the Hera Arena. So, well, thank you very much that you have made my day. I didn't really expect to see any of these here.
It was only a short while ago that you put the notice out there, so a lot of people probably didn't have the time to do it, to get the shirts in time to be here, but luckily for me, I did.
And considering the weather out there, we all should have gotten the sweatshirts.
I was just going to go there. I actually bought the sweatshirt, but I left it at home thinking, the weather's going to be too damn hot to wear it, and here we are freezing.
Well, you're in Canada. This is springtime.
Yeah. Actually, it's warmer in Vancouver when we left at 80 degrees yesterday, I think, and pretty cold down here at about 60 degrees, so... Anyway, nice to meet you guys, and thanks for having me on the air.
It's a pleasure to meet you in person. The first T-shirt for Ham Radio Now, right here at Dayton. You saw it, and where's yours, Jeff?
It's hanging. Oh well, you know, I don't have a T-shirt. All I have is these green button-up shirts.
And you didn't wear that either.
If I had a nice T-shirt, I'd probably be wearing it.
We'll see if we can fix you up.
Okay. All right.
Thank you so much.
Yeah, no problem. Earl V7QJ, over and out. You bet.
And we're back. Wasn't that awesome? He was wearing a Ham Radio Now shirt.
Yeah, triple the time machine.
Got himself on television. You got the mug and you've added a few more things.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, we've added some really cool products. We got a full line of licensed products now that we do.
Now these me look really cool.
Yeah, now that the SEC's not doing licenses anymore, as far as a printed license, we now offer them in three different versions of plaques. We actually have two different types of badges, coffee cup, and a new stainless steel mug that we just came out with.
Okay, coffee cup with your license printed on it.
Yep, just like your pocket license.
Yep.
And you're seeing my information on there.
You've expired. Your license is expired.
Yeah, I did that on purpose. then we have this little gem here, which has your license on one side and the ultimate band plan on the back.
Oh, cool. Until they change it.
Yes.
So thinking
until they change it again, then we got to go ahead
and
change
it. Take one step forward. We want to make sure you're still on camera.
Whoops.
There. No cameraman back there.
Yes, yes, yes.
I'm not paying anybody to be a camera operator. It's all just by itself. Yes. So, this is cool stuff. So the FCC, you can still get the FCC to send you a license.
You got to request it.
Hold that microphone up real
quick. You got to request it, yeah.
Yeah, but in order to get your license on one of these things, they don't need to send you a copy.
No. All they have to do is go to our website, hamshirts.com, pick out the product they want. They'll put in their call sign. What we'll do is I will go to the FCC's website, pull a reference copy, take the information off that. I will create it for them, ship it to them.
Yeah. If people haven't been to the FCC website, the ULS, they might not know that they can get They download a PDF with their license on it.
Wireless.fcc.gov.
Yeah, so you can get that. Anybody can get that of anybody's license.
They only thing about the reference copy is that you download, it says reference copy all the way through as a big watermark.
Ooh, yeah. That's no good.
Yeah.
I bet I could get rid of that. Photoshop.
We can do anything Photoshop now.
Okay. All right, so give me some ballpark prices on some of these things.
Sure. The small plaque, $16.95. The wall plaque, honey, if you could hand me that. This is my lovely wife, by the way, since everybody hasn't met her yet. This is our wall plaque. It's all solid wood. This is $18.95. This is an 8x10. And then we have our mega plaque, which we just come out with, which is a full 8x10. It's $22.95. This is the largest plaque that you'll find anywhere. And so, you know, it's kind of cool. The mug is $16.99 for the mug. I believe it's $16.99, $16.95, something like that. I'd have to go look. And these are $11.95 for the mug. In fact, all of our mugs are same price, $11.95.
So you can either get your license on it or where'd it go? Ah, there we go. My logo.
On it. Yeah. Or choose from one of our other...
You got a bunch of generics.
A bunch of them with your call sign. And we have some of them that mimic our shirts. Like if you notice on the corner, Real Radio's glow in the dark. That's just like our T-shirt. And you can get a mug to go with your T-shirt with your call sign on.
Okay.
Because
this is not really a paid advertisement, you're not the only person doing some of these things.
No. So
you've got competition. Yours are just better or cheaper.
Yeah. Well, yeah, what we're doing is with ours, we're just making sure we can give the highest quality of product available. It's like on our badges, they're very, very heavy material. It's not the real thin stuff that bends and breaks, and you know, it's made of a heavy material that's about an eighth of an inch thick that, you know, you can almost drag through the mud and it'll keep on going.
All right, so hamshirts.com.
Yes, sir.
And what else do we need to say?
Come see us at hamshirts.com.
I guess that's yeah. It.
Let us know you saw us on hamradio.com. Yeah.
And if I see you at Dayton this year with a Ham Radio Now shirt on it, I'll put you on the show.
Yeah. In fact, I'll tell you what. If someone sees you with one of the shirts on, I'll also throw in a mug.
Ooh. Well, there's a deal. Can't beat that.
How's that sound?
All right. Thanks a lot.
No problem.
I think we're done. I'm not sure this is going to be the end of a show or stuck in the middle. If it turns out to be the end of the show, over.
And out.